Hey all, welcome to ShareTreck. This is Raj here. Very happy to talk about CRISPR Therapeutics earnings for 2023. It's beyond expectations. Let's get started. Here we are on the earnings release in the CRISPR Therapeutics website. And I want to go through key points about this because there are a lot of really good information out here, which needs a little bit of reading. And I wanted to get this to you as early as possible. So look forward to another video on CRISPR Therapeutics where I'll drill down into specifics about the pipeline, which is what we are interested in. I want to give you the top line today, and maybe tomorrow or day after, I'll come back with a detailed video on the earnings release, focusing on the pipeline and how the quality of the pipeline has improved. So at a very high level, in terms of the pipeline achievements, we can talk about CASGEV, which has been approved for sickle cell disease and TDT. So that's already a given. All of us know about it. The new news that we have is that two in vivo programs targeting cardiovascular disease have entered into the clinical trials. And then they are talking about therapies in the pipeline where CASGEV has been approved in US, European Union, Great Britain, Bahrain, and Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, whereas regulatory submission under review in Switzerland and Canada, with submission planned for first half of 2024. The CTX112 and CTX131 next generation CAR T cell programs for liquid and solid tumors is in clinical trials ongoing with potential best-in-class outcomes according to CRISPR Therapeutics. And in vivo programs, CTX310 and 320, about which I made a video yesterday, targeting cardiovascular disease with lipid nanoparticular delivery, is underway. And we have some updates on CASGEV launch, progress in the United States with around 12 authorized training centers, and an agreement with Synergy Medication Collective. And then we have the launch progress outside of the US with authorized treatment centers in EU and Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, approval for early access program in France, and then the next generation CAR T candidate CTX112 to initiate a clinical trial for systemic lupus or SLE in first half of 2024. And that's again going to be a big catalyst, potential expansion into autoimmune indications with that particular clinical trial. And then we have CTX131 phase 1 trial for hematologic malignancies planned for first half of 2024, in vivo gene editing programs, ongoing phase 1 clinical trial for CTX310 and 320 targeting cardiovascular diseases. Additional in vivo programs targeting rare and common diseases expected to be disclosed in mid-2024. So in mid-2024, we'll get a bunch of catalysts. And when they disclose those diseases, there's a good chance that they might be announcing some which are already in collaboration with some big pharma. So that could be another catalyst. Then talking about regenerative medicine, we have information that ongoing phase 1 trial for CTX211 for type 1 diabetes, aiming for a beta cell replacement without chronic immunosuppression, is progressing. We don't have more details than that, but when I go through this earnings release in detail for the pipeline updates, I'll have more information for you. Then we have corporate financing, where they disclose that they've entered into an investment agreement for the sale of $280 million worth of common shares to institutional investors in a registered direct offerings. We already knew about that. I had made a video about it earlier. Then we are talking about cash position of $1.6 billion as of 31st of December 2023, and pro forma cash of greater than $2.1 billion as of February 21, 2024. So cash position is looking pretty strong. That was one of the reasons the cash position was not looking that strong to a bunch of investors. So we had a huge short buildup. Hopefully that gets cleared right now. And then we have financial result for Q4 2023. And when I look at the financial statement for Q4 2023, one of the biggest thing I notice is that for the first time, they have a positive quarter, and which seems sustainable. And they had a net income of $89.3 million for Q4 2023 as compared to a net loss of $110.6 million in Q4 of 2022. That's a substantial gain, and I believe it's going to be sustainable. R&D expenses decreased to $95.1 million. General and administrative expenses decreased to $16.5 million. Collaboration expenses increased to $20 million. And we have a little bit of update on collaboration with Vertex. Vertex leads global development, manufacturing, and commercialization of CASGEV, with a 60-40 cost and profit sharing arrangement. And the outlook is that we are expecting a catalyst-rich 12 to 18 months with innovations across therapeutics areas, including oncology, autoimmune, cardiovascular, and diabetes. This is the most upbeat sentence that I found in the JP Morgan 2024 disclosures. And I'm finding the same thing out here. So we can look forward to a lot of catalysts in the next 18 months. And some of them are going to be launch of clinical trials for preclinical candidates in the pipeline. And a few will be also announcement of collaborations for some of those with milestone payments. And of course, there will be more catalysts when more insurers are signed up and more ATCs are launched and made operational. So it all looks good. And then coming to my own holding, I had around 100 CRISPR Therapeutics shares, and I had sold covered calls at $100 strike price with the expiry on 1st of March. So first thing this morning, I bought them back at 75 cents, and I've squared my position, made a profit there, because I don't want to have any covered calls on CRISPR right now. So I took the opportunity of the early morning momentum. So I'm happy. So I hope you guys are also happy. Expect for a more detailed video on CRISPR Therapeutics with a focus on the pipeline progress, whatever they have mentioned, and also with a focus on Casgevy, how it is doing in terms of market penetration and revenue and costs. With that, I'd like to end this video. Thanks and have a great day. Bye for now.